Hilchos Shabbos, Perek Shleish Osor. Ein amoitzi, mershus l'shus, e amaver b'shus harab m'chus l'arba m'schayev, at sheyaker chayfetz mi'al gabi mokim sheyesh b'arba atfochim al bo atfochim l'yeser, v'yoniach al gabi mokim sheyesh b'arba atfochim al arba atfochim. So in other words, earlier we learned, previous Perek, we learned, that in order to make a haitzah, it has to be akira v'hanoch. Now we're saying that the akir and the hanoch has to be mi al gabi mokim dalet al dalet, on top of a mokim dalet al dalet. The akir has to be from a mokim dalet al dalet, and the hanoch has to also be on a mokim dalet al dalet. Masha'inkin, if it's not on a mokim dalet al dalet, so then you're not chayv. That's this new halacha. Now, the maisa is, there are some people that want to learn in Rambam as well. It's when Shalem Shat in the Gemara, that if there's something mechuber to the karka of the Rishus HaYochid or the Rishus HaRabim, so then even if it's not Dalar al-Dalar, it has a din of Dalar al-Dalar. So this din of Dalar al-Dalar is only when we're dealing with something portable in a Rishus. So the question is, if this item is Dalar al-Dalar or not Dalar al-Dalar. When you're dealing with something that's not portable, it's actually, it's attached to the ground, so then, and it has the din of the ground. We're not talking about, let's say, if it's a mokum tour, that's in a Rishus HaRabim, it's a different story. But if it's attached to the ground, so the Poshlan Rishus HaYochid, so then it'll have a din of Dalar al Dalar. We'll learn about it later. Halacha base. Yodi Shalodim, Shuvalei Karbo al Arbo. Lefichok. Im Okar Achefetz Miyad Odom Haimed Bushuzu. Vihiniche Biyad Odom Macher Haimed Bushushnia. So the Chur Yiltayne, it wasn't dalar al dalar. Nevertheless, you're chayv, because there's a din that Yodi Shalodim is Kshuvik dalar al dalar, because you hold things in your hand. So the pastos, the din of dalar al dalar is, because if it's not on dalar al dalar, it's like it's precarious. It's not really a dover munach. Masha'in came, if it's in your hand, so a hand is considered dover choshuv, or maybe there's another din of al kopon, a hand is considered Yodi Shalodim Kshuvik dalar al dalar. V'chein, im hoya oimed ba'achas m'shtei rishuyis elu, u'poshet yodu l'shushniya, v'okar achefetz mimeno, oim yad odom ha'imed bo, v'hirzer yodi elov, and you left it in your hand, it's still in your hand, because you didn't put it down, is also chayv. V'achol pishal yiniach achefetz m'mokum shu oimed bo, v'heil v'hu b'yodi, is areyo kumunach boretz. So, it's not so clear, what is the Rambam adding over here? The nekudas hadvarim is that even though you didn't actually put it down, well, lapel, you left it standing while it's in your hand, it's considered a hanocha. The fact that it's lying in your hand is considered a hanocha, as if it would be lying on the ground. I'm saying the question is over here a little bit, what's the chiddush? Is the chiddush is, Chur the Rambam is saying it, behemshech to yodi shalodim kshuvik dalar al dalet. And then the Rambam is saying that heil v'munach b'yodi is k'munach al oretz. But I'll call upon them, the din is that you're chayv. Halacha gimel. Hoya oichel v'yoytzi mershus l'shus v'chishev l'hoytzi ha'oichel shebepiv mershus l'shus chayef a'ay l'chure the piv is not a dalar al dalar l'shemachshavte misim mipiv mokim arbo aval pish l'heitzi g'derach ha'mitziyim. So the Magid Mishnah learns l'heitzi g'derach ha'mitziyim means that he took it from a place that's not dalar al dalar, but since it was hoytzik, since it was piv machshavte misim mokim dalar al dalar, that's the din of dalar al dalar. Not so clear. Because earlier the Rambam Taka said that when you moitzi bepiv, that's considered lehetzi gedar chamitzim. And over here the Rambam is saying you're chayiv because he wants to eat. He wants to eat there. So the mela, so he's not stamming moitzi bepiv. So that's cool. But the Rambam is still saying lehetzi gedar chamitzim. V'chein misha yoemet b'achatz m'shtei rishu yaseilu v'hishten mayim. A rokak b'shus shniya is chayiv. What's the shail over here? Also, shari okar m'shus, why? Shari okar m'shuzu v'inev b'shus shniya. I, l'churi, he was oikar from a place that's not dalar al dalar, say his mouth, hishtin, or by rokak, or by hishtin, is from desveg, m'achshavti, oisoy, kilu okar m'al gabi mokam arbo. So since he wants it to be where it is, so therefore, it has to be there, so therefore, that's considered also makom arbo. Hoya emet b'shuzu u'pi'am b'shushniya v'hishten b'potter. Because the Gemara has a clear. Because the shail is, where's the makom anocha of the shetan? If the makom anocha of the shetan is in the guf, or the makom anocha of the shetan is considered pi'am. And the melech, so paskin l'kula that you're potter. Hoye oymed ba'achas mishtei rishus. Uposhat yodi l'shushnia. V'notel mishtamayim mi'algabi gumam le'yamayim. V'hitziya nischayim. Why? Shamayim kulam ki'ilu hei menachem al aretz. So we don't look at it, you took the water from the water. All the water is lying on the ground, and therefore you took water from the ground, and the ground is took dal dal dal. Avim hoye keli tzafal gabi mayim. If you had a keli which was being was floating on top of the water, upeiris betecha keli upashed yodi v'lokach mena peiris ve'hitziyus poter. Why? Shareli nochu apeiris al gabi aretz. They were on the keli. The nimtza shali okar mi al gabi mokam arbo. So that's not because if you pick something up from the ground, it's mokam arbo. Masha'inkin, you're picking something up from the keli, so the keli is not considered a mokam arbo. Now, even if the keli was a mokam arbo, but the keli is not stationary. So since the keli is not stationary, so therefore the keli is also not considered mukhav. Ve'in tzorech le'im hoya aperis sofen al pnei amayim ve'itzion v'shehu poter. Because the peiris, you could say the peiris are stationary. More clarifies about it. The peiris are stationary on the keli. Masha'inkin, and the lepil da'aloch is that it's not like that. Masha'inkin, the keli, if the peiris are on the water, so for sure they're not considered munach al gabi mokam arbo al arbo. Because the water doesn't have a din of a mokam arbo al arbo, the pashtus. Ve'ein tzor v'chein, im hoi yishem tzof al pnei amayim. The kolat min hashemen v'hitziya is also potter, because the shemen and the mayim are considered two separate entities. The shemen doesn't mix with the water, so therefore, so lahalacha, so the shemen has a din that it's munich on the water, not it's munich on the ground, and therefore the water doesn't have a din of a mokim al bor al bo. The water be'etzim doesn't have a din of a mokim al bor al bo. Kvar amarnu she'ein ha'moitzi mershus l'rshus chayiv. Achiyakar vionyach. Avalum leyok, avalum okar vilehinyach, ehinyach vile okar potter. You have to do both the akir and the anach, the fichach. Misha yeemed, ba'achas mishterishiyas, the first mishnah misaf the Shabbos. Uposhet yodi lushushnia, vechefes biyodi, v'not lay achar mimenu. So the other person took it from his hands. The person that put it in didn't make the anach, the other person took it from his hands. Eishanosan achar liyodi chefes. Because in both cases, one made the hanochah, one made the akir. That we say that when the person takes it from your hands, it's considered that he made the hanochah, and you didn't make the hanochah. That's kshehoisi yodi lemaila mishleish. If your hand was extended, but it was higher than three tefachim of the ground, aval hoisi yodi b'teich shleisha. So now we're saying that when a person, let's say in the case there's a case of the balabayas sticking out his hand and giving it into the ani's hand. So that's for sure, that's chayiv. The balabayas made the akira and the anocha. What happens if the ani took it out of the balabayas' hand? So the balabayas made the akira and the ani made the anocha. A medvar mamurim, if the balabais's hand was l'mayla miyut. Masha'inkan or the balabais's hand was l'mata migimel, samuk l'aretz. See, even though the balabais is standing b'rishus ha'yochet, and his hand is extended into b'rishus ha'rab, but since his hand is samuk l'gimel, pachas migimel, samuk l'aretz, it's considered already munach b'aretz, and even if the oni is going to take it out of his hand, it's not a geah. Because l'pil, he made down nacha, the mere fact that the hand is there, and it's some chlor, that's considered anach. That's important. That's what he says. Hoya aimed halacha zayin. Hoya aimed b'achas mishtei rishuy yiselu. Uposhet chaver yodi mershushnia. V'notel chefetz miyadze ha'aimed b'shuzu. V'echnis yetzlei. Eshehetzi chefetz miyetzlei. V'iniach biyadze ha'aimed. Izze ha'aimed l'asakum. Because the person that was completely inactive, he wasn't, there's a case where ze'ekar v'zehiniach. But over here, there was a person made the akira and the hanocha, but he made the akira and the hanocha, and he placed it. Either he made the akira from someone's hands, or he made the hanocha on someone's hands. But he made the akira and the hanocha. Is there ha'emed le'osu klum, sherei chaveri nosen biyodi, enotel biyodi, v'chaveri chayim sherei yoker v'inia. So the person that let the other person do it didn't do anything wrong. Tesis brings that, and Tesis and Shabbos brings that, the fact that he's letting the other person take and give from his hands. But basically, from a Shabbistic point of view, for sure, he did absolutely nothing wrong. Someone takes something and places it on someone else's shoulders and someone's hands, and that person is stationary, he's standing, and then that person starts moving. So the person that put it on his hands did nothing. He took from one place in this rishus and he put it right next to it on another place in that rishus. And the other person that started moving, he made the akira, and then he made the anocha. So why? The fact that you're walking with something on top of you or you're holding something is considered an akira. And the fact that person stopped over there knows you don't have to actually pick something off from the ground and put it somewhere else. If you're standing and holding something. And so memela is considered munavishus ayachid. Now when you start walking, so that walking is considered the akira. Then when you stand, it's considered anach. Memela yachai. Lefichach. Im yotza b'chefet shebiyodi al gaba v'le yamad b'shus ishniyah. If you didn't stand in the next rishus, alachaza v'nichnas v'hu biyodi, and you came back before, you never stopped really in the other rishus. V'afilu yotza v'nichnas kol hayem kuli, you kept on going in and out. Why? When you started moving, after you had the item on you, when you were stationary, then you started moving. That was the akir. But you never made anocha. Even if you did make anocha somewhere, but the purpose of the anocha was to adjust the package, but it wasn't there to stop. Is a dain who potter achiyamid lenuach unless you stop to rest. Halacha Yud Gimel v'chein misha hoisa chavilosi al ksefei. So the gear, they changed. Some people change the gear, so they say rotzba. Whereas we're talking about a case that realizes that all of a sudden he walked out of a house and he has chavilosi al ksefei. So he made an akira. So what's the etzah? The etzah boy is rotzba. He should be rotzba. He shouldn't just keep walking, because we're soon going to learn that if you keep walking, so then it's considered midrabanan like an akira hanochev. You're just walking. So what you should do is rutzpah, you should run. Afilo kolayim kulei, but eini chayiv lupel, even if you're not rutz, as long as you keep walking, is eini chayiv achiyamid, you lupel, you didn't do an iser of hanocha, because unless you stand. Vahu sheyeh rutzpah, when is there a heter to be rutzpah? Avam holach ma'at ma'at, but if you just keep walking, ma'at ma'at, is areze kiminia ke'ekru miniach v'asa. So say smidr abanon, walking with an item when you're walking and not running, so it's considered like you're making akira and a hanach. The fichach mi shekidish olav ayem, the chavilosi al ksefei. So the eitz is ratzba achi yagia lebeisei. So therefore, you're not making akiras and hanachas, and therefore, and v'zor kisham kalachar yad, and you make the hanachah kalachar yad. Over there, you have to get rid of it. So you zor kisham kalachar yad, but you shouldn't just walk with it, because walking with it is midrabanan considered an akira hanach? Halacha yud. Okar chefes mishus harabim v'holach bepachas mi'arba amas v'amad v'chazir v'holach pachas mi'arba amas v'amad afilu kol hayem kulei is poter. It's a isad rabbanan. There's only certain cases that they were matter such a thing. Masha'in kein, but it's poter because lepel you stopped every you stopped before dalar amas. V'amed v'ar mamurim b'shamad lenuach. Avulim omad l'sakin masoi is a reza kimahalach. Ukshiyamid chutz l'arba'am is chayv. So if you stop l'sakin masoi, so then that's considered mahalach. V'hu shiyamid chutz l'arba'am is lenuach. When are you chayv? Ukshiyamid chutz l'arba'am is chayv. Ukshiyamid chutz l'arba'am is lenuach. Avulim yamid l'sakin masoi is then adayin ukimahalach. And therefore, v'ini chayv achiyamid lenuach chutz l'arba'am. So be kitzer. So if you maver pachas pachas mi arba'amis, you potter. But what does it mean pachas pachas mi arba'amis? That before you went arba'amis, you stopped, and that stopping was lo nuach. Masha'ekin, if the stopping was l'sakin masoi, that's not called stopping. Now maybe we discussed this. What happens if you stop not lo nuach and not l'sakin masoi? You stop because you know you're supposed to stop. You know you're supposed to stop, because if you're going to keep walking, so then you're going to be chayev. So over here, does that go into the gather that's not l'sakim masoy, so therefore it's considered l'nuach? Or it's not l'nuach, it's because you want to walk further, but it's not l'sakim masoy. That's a clear thing. Mishnah Berurah clears about it. And therefore, he's matzia that you have to like put down the package. And the Rambam doesn't say, l'chura, the pashtus advarim is as long as it's not l'sakim masoy, it's considered l'nuach. Halacha yudalf. A large item. So you have a large item. Instead of picking it up, you pick up one edge and you turn it over, and that's how you keep moving it. You have a long pole and you keep picking up one edge and turning it over, like throwing it over, but the other edge remains where it is. It's potter. There was never a proper akira because the whole time it was standing in one place. There's one part that was standing in one place that didn't move. If you take the item and you start schlepping it, so the entire item is moving, and you take this item, you put it dalet amos away from where it was lying. So there's dalet amos between where it was originally lying and where it's lying now. So then you're fine. Obviously, it has to be dalet amos completely. You know, the area where this was and the area where it's now, in between that these two areas, there's dalet amos. Halacha yud beis. Okar chefetz mizovizu. You pick something up with the intent of putting it in another corner of the room. There's no problem. You pick something up. You pick up a bottle in from the table. And you will put it on the counter. So there's nothing wrong. And v'nimlach baderech, while you're on your way, holding this bottle from the table to the counter, and you decided v'hitzir l'shusni, you took it outside. It's potter. Why? So the originally akira wasn't on the intent of bringing it out to Rosh Hashanah. The nimtzas kan hanochem leakira. The kena ikir chayfetz v'inichi al chaveri kshu mahalach. Early we spoke about when a person puts something on a chayfetz on a chaveri when he's stationary, and then that person walks out. But here he's putting it on a chayfetz on a chaver while he's walking. Not So he made the akira and he put it on someone that was walking, and then he made the anocha before that person stopped. Is a raise the potter. So even though the chori, you made the akira and you made the anocha, shari yesh kan akira b'le anocha. Because the akira and the anocha aren't connected. You made the akira, you put it on top of someone, and then later on, even though you made the anocha, but there's no connection. Akira and anocha, the connection is only if you made the akira. And then you made the havar, and then you made the hanocha. That's l'chura pshat. Because l'chura, we're talking about over here that you made the akir and the hanocha. You not al gab chaveri, but nevertheless, there's akira. The akir and the hanocha aren't connected. And al derech zeh, next thing. Hazeir chayfes mershus l'shus, e mitchilis arba l'seif arba b'shus haram, v'kedem shiyonuach, kol te'acher b'yodei, e kol te'kelev e'nisraf. So as you threw something, so obviously if the thing would land, so you made the akira and the anocha. You were accurate and you called that it should make anocha. But over here, instead of it landing on itself, so something else went and grabbed it. Someone else grabbed it with his hand, or someone else, a dog grabbed it, or it got burnt. So you never really made the anocha. It's part of it. So okay. In other words, if a person throws something with the intent of someone else grabbing it. So even though the other person grabbing it, so that was l'chatchila, the intent of what you do. So because the hanocha, what you wanted to make, happened. And it's considered that you made the hanocha. Although l'chura, let's say a person takes something out, and then someone else takes that out of your hand, so that person made the hanocha. So l'chura over there also, that person grabbed it. You could tie it, that person made the hanocha, you didn't make the hanocha. But since, in other words, you threw it with the intention of reaching his hand, and that person grabbed it. So that's considered you made that nacha. You have to explain it, that it's considered you made that nacha, even though he grabbed it. Because if he grabs it out of your hand, let's say you bring something into the Rishus HaRav, and the intent is that he should grab it out of your hand. Well, apparently you didn't make that nacha. But when you throw something, see, even though it didn't really fall, it was grabbed, but nevertheless, since you had that intent, it's considered you made the hanacha. Maybe it needs a little bit further clarification. Halacha yudalot. Hazerik chefetz mershus lishus. V'yekesh kosher b'chevel v'egde b'yodei. So it was still tied to a string, and you're still holding the string. Zim yochel limshecha chefetz atzlei is potter. Shari inkan hanacha gmura. V'nimtza k'misha akar v'lehinich. So in other words, if you're still capable of pulling it back, so it's considered that it wasn't really a proper hanacha. Hazerik, the nacha b'teich yodei shel chaveri. So again, im omad chaveri b'mkeim avikibla zazerik chayv, shari akar v'nech. You threw a fly ball and it landed in this person's hand, so that's fine. Or a straight ball. V'im nekar chaveri b'mkeim avikibla, that person had to go run and catch it. So then it's potter. Now, l'chura over here is the same thing like before, like we had by Koltosi Kelef. And l'chura over here should also be the same din, that if you're in the original intent of Nekar Chavere, should be Chayev. And over here, the Ram doesn't say it. He doesn't really say that if your intent was that he should go grab it. Over here, he said it. Kolti Achir B'yodei, but Nischav M'shah Zrika L'kach is Chayev. He's talking about Achir also. Achir, a Kelev on Israf. So I'm not sure why over here, it's also repeating that halacha that we said before. So because if you throw something and it lands where it was meant to land, you're chayav. If the other person goes ahead, neker chaverim came and he grabs it, so you're potter. However, l'chura, we learned earlier that was your original intent. So you're also chayav, even though the Rambam doesn't say it more. Yeah. Now, zarak v'rotz hazerik atzmi achra chefetz. Person throws something and he runs himself. V'kiblei biyodei b'rshus acheres, echut la'arba'amas, is potter, ke'ilu neker acher v'kiblei. So that's the same thing of kiblei acher. Even though l'chura, you made the akira, you made the hanacha, because you were kiblei acher, but l'peil she'ena hanacha gemura, at she'yonuach ha'chefetz, b'mokim she'hoyelei l'nuach b'sha'as akira. So the problem over here is that it didn't really land, b'mokim she'hoyelei l'nuach b'sha'as akira. It landed in your hand, you ran. So it was supposed to land on the ground, and now you grabbed it. Now, what happens if you originally intended on throwing it and running and grabbing it? So it's again the same shiloh. Earlier in Halacha Yud Gimel, he said that if you throw something, you intend that someone else should grab it, you're chayiv. Over here, some Halacha Yud Dalet Tezvov, he's not mentioning that. It's not legabi the other person, and sign not legabi yourself. So I don't know. Halacha tezayin. Hazeik mishus hayochid lishus hayochid. Rishus harabim b'emtza. Afal pisha over hachefetz ba'aver rishus harabim poter. Vuhu shiyaver lamayil mishleisha tfochim. Avalim ovar mishpochis mishleisha tfochim mishleisha somuch l'oretz. V'noch al gabi mashu. Afal pisha nekar in his galgul v'yotza hachefetz lishus hayochid ho'acheres. So when someone throws something from Rishus HaYochid to Rishus HaYochid, and it passes Rishus HaRabim, so if it didn't land in Rishus HaRabim, you're potter, but there was no Hanoch in Rishus HaRabim. But the Chiddush is that if the item was Pachas Mishleisha Samach L'Oretz, and it landed on something, it touched something, even though it didn't really remain there, or even really in reality, even if it somehow or another it stayed still in the ground for a moment, it still stays still in the air for a moment. So then it's in its pachas midal ramas, pachas migibul tvachim samach l'aretz. So it's considered that it was munah. So if you throw a ball from Rishus HaYochid to Rishus HaYochid and you bounce it through the Rishus HaRabim, so even though it didn't stay in the Rishus HaRabim, but since it came pachas midal migibul tvachim samach l'aretz, it touched the ground, even though it bounced into the other Rishus, yuchayv. Is also potter, and the same thing. The other achefetz, the pachas mishleisha samuch l'aretz v'nochal gabi mashu. Aval pisher chazar v'nizgalgul v'yotzul l'shusarab mashniyah. is a rezek mishen nishar eme b'shus hayachad u'fichachay. So that's a special din, that if something is pachas migimul samach la'aretz, it's considered munach b'aretz. Hamavir arba'am is b'shus harabim zu, im r'shus harabim ha'shniya. It's chayif. Mipnei sh'arba'am is b'shtei r'shus ishuyas harabim mitztarfim. Mipnei sh'linoch ha'chefetz b'shus shabinei. So if a person carries two amas and one r'shus harabim, and vice versa, he's passing, let's say, or Shus HaYochid, there's a row of houses, which is Shus HaYochid, and that's separating the Shus HaRabim. There's one Shus HaRabim and another Shus HaRabim, and he carries two Amos and one Shus HaRabim, and he passes by Shus HaYochid, and he carries two Amos and the next Shus HaRabim. So then he's Chayiv. Why? Because Leinocha Chayfetz B'Shus HaBinayim. You need a Churat Tzarech Bir. We learned earlier that the gather of Dalet Amos is that a person's, he has an area next to him, which is Dalet al Dalet, and if he carries chutz from that area, he's chayev, and that's why he gets the Alach Seinon. So over here, the Chorah also talking Alach Seinon. So, I mean, so how does that work when we're talking about two Rishuyas? I don't understand exactly how these two Rishuyas Rabbins fit with what we learned earlier, that when you carry chutz from Dalet Amos, means chutz from Dalet Amos v'Alach Seinon. Halacha Yudches, Hamoishet Mishus Hayochid L'Shus Hayochid, U'Rishus HaRabim Be'amtza. So there's a new din of Moishet. Moishet Mishus Hayochid L'Shus Hayochid L'Shus HaRabim Be'amtza. Va'afilo Hoishet L'mayla Mi'avir L'Shus HaRabim. In other words, when it went over the Rishus HaRabim, it went L'mayla Mi'utfachim. So you're Chayef. So din, Hamoishet Mishus Hayochid L'Shus Hayochid L'Shus HaRabim Be'amtza Chayef. Va'afilo Hoishet L'mayla Mi'avir L'Shus HaRabim. Shekein hoisa avedes halavim b'mikdash, mishkon, mishitnes akroshim mi'agolu la'agolu, u'rishus harabim b'shtei ha'agolis, v'chol ha'agolu v'agolu rishus ha'yochidei. So they had the wagons that they carried the kroshim. So they had the two wagons in the length of the rishus harabim. So what happened was they would take from the mishkon, they would put the keresh from the ground to the agolu. Then they would take it from one agola and they would put it onto the next agola. So Mela came out that they were moishet from the agola, which was the Rishus HaYochid, to the next agola, which was another Rishus HaYochid. Derech, the aver, which was between the two agolas, which was an aver Rishus HaRabim, and that was the melacha. Even though really the aver, which were between the two agolas, were lemaila miyut, so therefore the chur, it's not an aver Rishus HaRabim. But nevertheless, that was the melacha, therefore yachai. So it comes out a new din that a moishet Rishus HaYochid, Rishus HaYochid, Derech Av Rishus HaRabim, Evil Amayel Miyud is Chayef. But Bamedvar Mamurim, Shehoyu Shtei Rishus HaYochid, Be'erek Rishus HaRabim. If they were along the length of the Rishus HaRabim, Kimei, Shehagolus, were Mahalchus Rishus HaRabim, Zu Acher Zu, so the two Agolus were in the length of the Rishus HaRabim. Avalim Hoyu Shtei HaRishuyas, Bishnei Tzidir Rishus HaRabim. In other words, the width of the Rishus HaRabim separated between the two Rishus HaYochids. Is af hamishet b'shus hayochid zul b'shus hayochid shekneg depotu. So it'll come out that say you know you have two porches on the side of the street. So if you're moishet from one porch to the other porch and there's an airspace in between, even though this airspace is l'mayla miyud above the ground, you're chayev. Masha'inkin if there would be two porches on two sides of the street, so mele and you're handing from one porch to the other porch. So even though you're handing the same thing b'shus hayochid derek b'shus harabim. But since it's across the width of the Rishus HaRabim, as opposed to the length of the Rishus HaRabim, so that wasn't the Aveda, the Mishkan, and then Lechabei El Chidushim. Halacha Chof. Shachach uposhat yodei, vihi mulei peiris, vihi tziyo mechotzer zu, lachnisa lechotzer shebetzido. There's two chotzeres, and you stick out your hand and to give it to the chotzer shebetzido. V'nisker kedem shen yachnis, before he put it into the other chosim, now he has a hand which is extended into Rishus HaRabim, and with male payers. Vadiyodi Tluya Ba'av Rishus HaRabim is Muta Lachzira Elav Lachatzir. He could bring it back. Aval Hachnisu Lo'isa Achotzer Ashni Osu. Kidei Shli Osu Machshavte Shechosh Bishash Gogo. In other words, the Amos was a Shegik. He really shouldn't be Machnas from one Rishus HaYochid to the other Rishus HaYochid Derech Av Rishus HaRabim. He shouldn't be doing that. Masha'inkin, he made a mistake. He forgot. He stuck out his hand into the chotzer, and now he wanted to put it into the other chotzer. So the din is, so since he reminded himself, so he could bring his, he didn't do anything wrong so he could bring his hand back. But on the other end, he shouldn't put it there because doing what he did was really something that wasn't permitted. And therefore, Shiliyasa Makshafta. Abidin Heitzi Yadi Mimezid. Hareza Osir Lavzira Etzle. Ela Konsuese Shetehe Yadi Pluya Achetechshach. Now, it's not so clear. In Gemara, the big machlek is what exactly the seer is. But Lechura, the Hamshach HaRambam, it sounds like that he was being moishe from Lechura, maybe you could say, that he was being moitzi his hand, shachach u'pashad yadei, and he was being moitzi. In other words, he was talking about two chatzeres, and there was a reshus harab mamza. So nachem ol, this halacha, shachach u'pashad yadei, v'yitziyah mechatzizu lachmisa lechatzu shemachzidah, and situya ba'av reshus harab. And lechura, if he would actually do it, he would be doing the iser of being meishet reshus hayachad reshus hayachad, derech reshus harab. That's what it sounds like. He was being even the iser of being meishet reshus hayachad reshus hayachad derech reshus harab. So if he would have done it, he would have done an iser. If he's going to continue doing it, so he'll end up doing it. He did the first part, b'shegig, and the end of it, b'iser. So l'chur, he shouldn't be yosem achshavte, because it's a ma'aseh iser. L'chur, what's the chiddush that he shouldn't put it into the chotzer? L'chur, it's poshut. L'achnis l'etz achotzer shnei, k'dei sh'li yosem achshavte, sh'chosh b'shah shgoga. L'chur, he's doing a ma'aseh avera. Yeah. But if it was Heitzi Yadi B'mezit, so then it's Osir. There's in thesis, there's a lot of issues in Pshat. But Nachamol, let's read that halacha again. Halacha Chof. Shachach u'poshet yadi v'himalei aperis, v'yitziya michotzer zu lachnisa lachotzer shek b'tzida. And v'nisker kedem shiachnis, v'ari yadi tluya ba'avar shus harab. And l'chura, we're talking about what we just said before, that ha'meshim v'shtayach v'shtayachim, that shus harab is Osir. So he had intention of doing that. Is muta lavzira elav lechatzeri, aval lachnis leis achatz ashni osur. Kedei shli yosem machshavtei shechos b'shach shgoga. L'chura, what's the chiddush? L'chura, he's doing a ma'aseh iser. So Enoch Nami, when he stuck out his hand, he didn't realize it's a ma'aseh iser. But if he's going to finish it, so it's going to come out that he did a ma'aseh iser. T'chilosu b'shegu sefu b'mezit. So there's no. But l'peil is a ma'aseh iser. What's the chiddush? Maybe the chiddush over here. The hoitzi yadi b'meizid is a reza also lavzir atzli. The consuasion should say yadi tluya atzutash. Alacha chafalv. Hamischavin lizik shmei naamis b'shus harabim v'noch hachefetz b'seif arba chayiv. Shari nase kishir amalacha v'nase machshavte. In other words, he did a shir and is also ay lechur. He didn't mean it to land in shmeina. Good. Shadav yadua shein za hachefetz magia l'seif shmeina. So he intended on going on Arba, so he intended on making Akir, intended on making Anocha. He wanted to make the Anocha there, but Lepel, he ended up making the Anocha here. So it's also Chayv. It's a Chidush. L'chur, he didn't want to make the Anocha here. But since he wanted to pass here and he wanted to make Anocha, so he's Chayv for the Anocha that he's done here. Avil Mischav, Lizig Arba, Vizorek, Vinoch, Hachev, Vizek, Shmeina, Potter. If you should know, b'makim shuli chashish shetazim taverbe, he mechatchil didn't have an intent of it ever reaching eight amos. The koshkin shetanuach, so he didn't want it to go there. He certainly didn't want it to nuach. Lefichach im chashish beizrika shiyanuach achefetz bechol makim sheyirza, bechol makim she wherever is chayif. Yeah. Zorak uteich arba amos v'nizgal gal chutz l'arba amos. His intent was to throw something in arba amos. And it ended up being Lutech Arbamas is Potter. Zorak Chutz L'Arbamas, and it is Galgal Lutech Arbamas. So it depends. Im Nochal Gabi Mashal Chutz L'Arbamas, if it landed there on top of something, and Ve'achar Kach Nizgalgal V'nichlis Lutech Arbamas is Chai. Because Lepel, Enoch Nami, later on, it came with Lutech Arbamas, but Lepel, it was since it was Nochal Gabi Mashal Chutz L'Arbamas is Chai. Im Le'Noch Klal is Arezah Potter.